Hello everyone, and welcome to our operating demonstration. This is MedXtractor's 1 pound extractor. The system is partially assembled here, and I will run through the components so you see what is all involved in this. Over here, we have a 20 pound CO2 tank. This is the same kind of CO2 that is used for carbonating beverages in any kind of a restaurant, beverage grade CO2. Wrapped around that is a band heater. This provides heat to the system because the system consists of a warm side versus a cold side, which I will get into in just a moment. Okay, so the CO2 will flow from this warm side tank, supply tank. It will run through the extraction chamber. It will pick up extract as it runs through the extraction chamber, and it will be released into the collection chamber here. The CO2 will drop its extract load in the collection chamber, and the extract will run down to the bottom. The CO2 will run out of here, run down this recapture hose, which goes over here into this freezer, where there is a duplicate of the supply tank, but it's empty. So you have a full supply tank here, you have an empty recapture tank here. Once the process is complete, the supply tank will be empty and the recapture tank will be full. Then the tanks are swapped and the process can repeat itself. And by doing it that way, you can recapture greater than 80% of the CO2. Very often, in a properly configured system, we can get up to 95% recapture of the CO2. But that's basically how it works. So we don't use mechanical pumps, and the way that we avoid using mechanical pumps is we apply heat here. The heat will always go to cold. It will always migrate there. So as long as we've got a temperature differential with this side being warm and this side being cold, the CO2 will flow. The larger that differential, the faster the flow will be. But there is an optimum point for that. And the way that we control that flow rate is by this valve that's right here. You can't really see it from there, but there's a solenoid valve behind here, and it is controlled by this timer. And this timer will pulse this valve open and close. For the purposes of this 16-ounce extraction, we will set it at a default of 2 seconds open and 33 seconds off. And we're gonna run that on-off sequence for 2 hours and 15 minutes. At the end of that 2 hours and 15 minutes, this tank will be depleted and this recapture tank in the freezer will be full and it will be time to swap it. You can expect that to fully extract a 1 pound raw material load, you will have to use 4 supply tanks to do that. So you have to swap it 4 times. The entire process, you can expect it to be anywhere from 8 to 11 hours, including all of the swaps and everything else that has to happen, okay? So I'm gonna start the actual process at this point in time, and we'll see how things work out. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do then is I'm going to point you to this. This is the insert that goes in the top of the extractor. It needs to be fully seated down. There's an O-ring seal on there, and this is the retainer ring that keeps that insert in place. This insert is actually the sealing mechanism. So this, when you're putting this on, this retaining ring, you don't have to put it on very tight, because all it does really is hold it in, hold the O-ring on the insert in place. So when you're doing this, it's really a matter of doing it to that. Okay, so that's as tight as you need to do it, just finger tight like that. Okay, so that's set up like that. And then I'm going to put these hoses on here because this is the supply hose. This is where the CO2 comes in. And I wanna show you how tight you should tighten these things because it's not as tight as you would think. These fittings are very good at sealing. So we'll put this on here, take this wrench like this. And you see what I'm doing here is I'm just using basically 2 fingers. And I just go like that. And that's as tight as you need it to be. Then I will connect the what we call the bypass line. And I'll explain to you what this is all about in a moment. So we put that on there. Again, we take the wrenches and we tighten it up like this. Okay, we do this, just like that. And that's on. Now, by the way, just while I'm here, I'm gonna show you that when you take these off, let's just take this off and I'll show you just how easy it is to do that. So you do this, you just go like this, just like that. And now you can just finger take it off, just like that. It's as simple as that. These fittings can be used many, many, many times. I've never had one fail. Okay, so let's tighten it up again, like that, okay. Now, what I'm going to do now is this collector is equipped with a digitally controlled heater. The reason we do that is because when the CO2 flows through into here, it decompresses very rapidly, and that requires a large amount of heat transfer that goes on. And the heat that is lost by the decompression, we need to add it into the, add it back into the system to keep things from freezing up. So what I'm going to do right now, these things, by the way, these controllers come preset. So all you really need to do is start it. Okay, we can hear it. And this is going to run the temperature up to about 60 degrees Celsius and pre-warm this. And it will automatically shut off at that point. There's a thermostat in here. And this is going to run for about 2 hours and 25 minutes, which is 10 minutes longer than the timing sequence we're going to put on this timer. So basically, when you start this up and you get it all running, you can walk away and come back a couple of hours later. As a matter of fact, if you wish, you could come back 5 weeks later. It doesn't really matter how long you sit in between, because it's an automated process at that point, and it will shut itself off. Okay, so at this point in time, we are going to check all the valves. Okay, close them all. This. Okay, that valve over there is closed, and we're now ready to start the extraction. Okay. First thing we're going to do, I'm going to open this valve right here. That will pressurize the line. Now, the pressure inside this tank right now, when you're sitting at about 30 degrees, anywhere between 30 and 35 degrees, it'll be running somewhere around 1,000 PSI to 1,100 PSI. That's typically what you would get out of a supply tank. When you get a supply tank full, a 20-pound supply tank, it will only contain about 14 pounds of liquid CO2. The other 6 pounds is gaseous CO2. And we want to start with liquid CO2, and that's why this tank has what's called a dip tube inside it, which goes down to the bottom of the tank and delivers liquid CO2 from the bottom. If you do not have a dip tube tank, you have to turn the tank upside down. Not a big deal. So now we have this line pressurized like this, and now what we're going to do is we're going to fill up the extractor with CO2. When we do this, it will equalize with the supply tank, and it will also be about two-thirds full of liquid CO2. Okay, so let's start that process right now. I'll turn this on. Let's make sure that that's off. Yeah, okay. So here we go. So now it's filling up. Once the extractor is filled, after about a minute, it will come up to about here, about same level as it would in the supply tank. These things will equalize. Now we want to get rid of the gas head. And in order for us to do that, what we have to do is we have to shut off the main feed coming in, like this, okay, because we want the feed to come in from the base. And that's going to push the liquid up and push the gas head out. So the way that we do that is that we open this valve, which is the bottom feed valve. And now what happens is the CO2 that's coming in from the supply tank through this line here will go into this line down here, go in through this valve and go in through the base of the extractor and push it up. And the gas head will come out this valve and go into the bypass line and into the tank that's over here. So in order for us to make that happen, what we're going to do is we will open this tank valve that's in here in the freezer. It is now open. Okay. And we're going to do this. Remember, at this point, we're about two-thirds full. So now we're going to do this and get rid of the gas head. Okay, so here we go. You can hear it flowing. And after about that long, 4 to 5 seconds, that level will have come up considerably. So now what we have is a topped up system. We can close off this valve. We can open this valve back up again, shut the cheater valve off, and we're back in operating mode. Now the extraction has actually begun at this point in time. We will wait typically about 15 minutes to allow the carbon dioxide to dissolve some of the extract. And then after that, we're going to start the sequence. Again, we've already set this as pre-warming, so it's warming up, it's already there. We can see that that's already sitting around 60 degrees Celsius. We're going to put the timer on. Again, the settings are 2 seconds open the valve, 33 seconds close the valve. Repeat that for 2 hours and 15 minutes. All we need to do to start that is to confirm this button right here. And there it is. It has begun. Now we'll open this valve. Pardon me, that valve's already open. And the system is now running completely quietly. 2 seconds on, now it's 33 seconds off, and that is the sequence that we'll repeat for the next 2 hours and 15 minutes. At this point in time, the system is running nicely. We can leave. Okay, we're back. 2 hours and 15 minutes, actually 2 hours and 25 minutes. The digital collector heater has automatically shut off. It's warm to the touch, but it's certainly not hot by any means. The timer has shut off, and the system is sitting in stasis at this point in time. Now what we want to do is we want to swap the tanks. But before we swap the tanks, we want to take the residual CO2 that's in the supply tank and run it directly into the recapture tank in order to make sure that we've got a full load in the recapture tank and a fully depleted supply tank. We want to shut off the collector valve, and we want to open this valve here, which is the cheater valve, to allow the CO2 to come from this tank directly into here, run right across the top of the chamber inside here and out here, and bypass this and go into the tank over there. And when we do that, this is a direct transfer that's going on right now. And because this tank is much warmer than the tank in the freezer, the CO2 will flow. It is typical when this process is finished, before you do the equalization, is that there will still be probably 3 or 4 pounds of CO2 in there that is that you want to put from there into here. So you would just turn this valve open, and it will run straight through there, and you let it run until the pressure gauges equalize. Once that is done, we shut off all of the valves to isolate the tanks. Here's an isolation valve here, so we isolate this by closing this. All right, we turn this off, okay, like that. This is shut off, so it's isolated, so now the CO2 can't get out this way, and the CO2 can't get out this way, so that means that this is still pressurized, the collector and the extractor. Now we're going to do a tank swap. So if we go inside here, we close the recapture tank main valve that's in here, okay? Now we want to depressurize this line, okay? So what we're going to do here to depressurize that is to open this relief valve, which is right here. Open a little bit like that. You can hear that. Okay, now that's all it takes. The line is now depressured. So we can take off that tank, we can take off this tank, and we can swap them. Now we take our trusty crescent wrench, and we loosen off this, because there's no pressure there. Okay, so we take this out, and all we're doing is getting rid of the CO2 that's right here. Do that. This is going to go in the freezer. This is going to be the new recapture tank. These are coolant bags. They're full of glycol. Clean it up. Put our coolant bag back on top, like this. And close this. This is our standby supply, which is basically another bottle of CO2. Fill it up, turn it on. Now we're gonna wait for this to have a little bit of heat applied to it to bring it up to, you know, 900 to 1000 PSI before we open the valve and hit the timer and start this process running again. So in summary, what you've seen here is how to operate the 16-ounce system. Again, it's a thermodynamic process requiring no mechanical pumps. We use heat to cause motion to the CO2, to push the CO2 through the extraction column, pick up any extract that it's going to pick up, bring it out and deposit it in a timely fashion in the collection chamber, and then have the CO2 recaptured in the cold side of the system. This is the second law of thermodynamics, and this is what makes the system work and allow you as a small scale grower to have all of the benefits of carbon dioxide extraction without the costs.